Well, attention everyone, we have some exciting news for you. It must be love, as Honda makes technology you can enjoy. And it has launched one of its most popular models for 2024, the CR-V. We bet you're way more excited than us, but is it an EV or an FCEV? And what do these terms even mean? What's new in this model? Is it worth your while? You'll get to know the answers to all that and more here at Tech Addicts. So what are we waiting for? Let's start our engines already. Honda Motor has stated that it plans to implement its two autonomous driving technologies in full by the year 2030. By the year 2030, all new Honda and Acura cars in the United States will come equipped with the Honda Sensing 360 technology. AcuraWatch is Acura's answer to Honda Sensing 360. At the same time, Honda announced it will increase the availability of its Honda Sensing Elite system. According to a press release, Honda's latest safety advancements reflect a global vision announced by Honda Global CEO Toshihiro Mibe in April 2021 to strive for zero traffic collision fatalities involving Honda motorcycles and automobiles globally by 2050 and carbon neutrality for its products and corporate activities by 2050. In China, Honda already sells vehicles equipped with assisted driving technology of the first generation, which helps reduce blind spots and keeps drivers alert. A hands-free feature for driving in heavy traffic and highways are among the technologies included in the upgrade, the company stated. The driver can use this feature to take their hands off the wheel during parking, entering and exiting highways, and other maneuvers. Honda said that the AI-based technology learns from its past mistakes. Honda Sensing Elite increases its potential to recognize complicated surroundings and handle driving circumstances that occur in complex contexts, such as on non-expressways. Honda has not provided any official release dates for Honda Sensing Elite. Honda also announced recently plans to begin manufacturing the all-new Honda CR-V, a hydrogen fuel cell-powered vehicle, in the United States beginning in 2024. Honda has stated that its new zero-emissions vehicle, along with its innovative driving systems, will help the firm reach its objective of having 100% of its global auto sales be BEVs and FCEVs by the year 2040. The company claims that the new CR-V-based FCEV will be the first production vehicle in North America to combine a plug-in feature with FCEV technology in a single model, allowing the driver to charge the onboard battery to provide EV driving around town and the flexibility of fast hydrogen refueling for longer trips. Automobiles will be produced at the company's Performance Manufacturing Center, or PMC, in Marysville, Ohio. To emphasize its emphasis on workmanship and hand assembly, Honda referred to the PMC as a small-volume specialist manufacturing plant. The PMC opened in 2016, and since then, it has purchased the Acura NSX hypercar, several Acura PMC Edition automobiles, including the TLX, RDX, and MDX, and Honda Performance Development race cars. Because of this, Honda claims the PMC is well-suited for the construction of high-quality FCEVs. The corporation promised that more information about the vehicle will be provided as the year 2024, when it is scheduled for release, approaches. Let's talk about BEVs and how it's different from FCEVs. All of a battery electric car's power comes from its batteries, which are recharged whenever the vehicle is plugged into an electrical outlet or a charging station. There are several BEVs on the market, but some examples are the Nissan Leaf, Fiat 500e, and Tesla Model S. These vehicles have no gasoline engine, larger electric driving ranges compared to PHEVs, and never emit exhaust emissions. However, there are emissions connected with charging these vehicles. The BEVs on the market today normally go approximately 60 to 80 miles per charge, while a Tesla can travel over 200 miles on a single charge. According to a recent survey conducted by UCS, 69% of U.S. drivers believe that a BEV with a range of 60 miles would be sufficient for their needs on a weekly basis. As battery technology continues to improve, BEV ranges will expand much farther, allowing an even larger number of drivers the option of driving purely on electricity. FCEVs are similar to BEVs in that they include an electric motor, but they store energy in a very different way. FCEVs have hydrogen gas stored in a tank instead of a battery. In FCEVs, hydrogen and oxygen are combined in the fuel cell to generate power. A fuel cell generates electricity, which is used to power an electric motor, which drives the vehicle in the same way that a BEV does. Like BEVs, the only thing coming out of the tailpipe of an FCEV is water. There is no smog forming or climate-altering pollutants. FCEVs, on the other hand, may be recharged in as little as 5 minutes at a hydrogen filling station, unlike BEVs and PHEVs, which require an external charging source. At the 2015 Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, Toyota debuted its 2015 FCEV. However, the production of hydrogen generates pollutants in the same way as the production of electricity to charge a plug-in vehicle does. Today's hydrogen production process using natural gas results in nearly the same total emissions per mile as using electricity generated using natural gas to charge a plug-in vehicle. However, hydrogen produced using sustainable energy sources like biomass or solar power is virtually emission-free. Moreover, the infrastructure for hydrogen fueling, such as public charging stations for electric vehicles, is still in its infancy and is primarily located in California. FCEVs have the potential to play a significant role in our future transportation networks if state and federal governments establish policies to encourage the widespread adoption of these cars. Let's compare Honda CR-V with its rival for a long time, Toyota's RAV4 for 2024. Two of the most well-known and well-liked compact SUVs on the market are the Toyota RAV4 and the Honda CR-V. Both of these automobiles have an excellent combination of style, performance, and features, which makes them perfect options for commuters as well as families. However, which of these options is preferable? When it comes to performance, both of these automobiles provide an excellent combination of power and fuel economy. A four-cylinder engine displacing 2.5 liters provides propulsion for the RAV4, which results in 203 horsepower and 184 pound-feet of torque. Powered by a turbocharged four-cylinder engine displacing 1.5 liters, the CR-V generates 190 horsepower and 179 pound-feet of torque. Both of the engines are connected to a continuously variable gearbox, or CVT, which is designed to improve efficiency and reduce fuel consumption. The EPA estimates that the RAV4 achieves 28 miles per gallon in the city and 35 on the highway, while the CR-V achieves 30 miles per gallon in the city and 34 on the highway. When it comes to the features found within the vehicle, both options provide a wealth of conveniences to keep you relaxed and connected while you're on the road. The Toyota RAV4 is equipped as standard with a 6-speaker audio system and an infotainment system that features a touchscreen measuring 8 inches and is compatible with both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. The Honda CR-V is equipped as standard with a 7-speaker audio system and an infotainment system that has a touchscreen display of 7 inches and is compatible with both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as well. The front seats of both cars may be heated, and a power sunroof and wireless charging are among the optional extras available on both models. Both of these automobiles come equipped as standard with a suite of driver assistance technologies, such as adaptive cruise control, lane keep assist, and automatic emergency braking. These safety systems are designed to make driving easier and safer. There are also optional features available for the RAV4, such as a monitoring system for blind spots and an alarm for rear cross traffic. A lane departure warning system and automatic high beam control are two of the optional features on the Honda CR-V. Both of the vehicles have a sufficient amount of space in the trunk for you to store all of your belongings. The RAV4 has a total of 69 cubic feet of cargo capacity available, with 37 cubic feet available behind the second row of seats when those seats are folded down. When the second row of seats are folded down, the CR-V's total load capacity increases to 75 cubic feet from the standard 39 found behind those seats. Both the Toyota RAV4 and Honda CR-V for 2024 are, all things considered, excellent choices for buyers in the market for a dependable small SUV. Both of these automobiles provide excellent performance, an abundance of features, and a price that is comparable to other vehicles in their category. In the end, the answer to the question of which one is best for you will be determined by the specific requirements and preferences that you have. The road will never be the same. Hey, that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed our video, please give us a thumbs up, make sure you like it, and share it with all your friends and family and fellow auto fans who are in your inner circle. And if we can ask you one more favor, friends, please make sure you subscribe to Tech Addicts. Press that bell icon, and you'll always be notified of the latest uploads on our channel, and you'll always stay informed. Thanks for spending time with us today, and we'll do it again soon. Have a great day.